Hello everybody, welcome to judycentral.com online classes for law exams. So today I will be discussing with you the much demanded expected questions for Viva Voce ILI LLM admissions 2021. So like as all of you know, your Viva Voce examination will start from 12th of October 2021 from 10 a.m. onwards. I have already shared the schedule with you in the community tab page. And like many of you have requested me to do a session on that because most of you are having this query as to what is Viva Voce and how everything shall take place and how we shall appear for this examination. So let us start. So first of all, I would deal with you the LLM program of ILI, that means Indian Law Institute, Delhi. So let me tell you, this institute offers 1 year LLM program that is consisting of 2 semesters. Intake is 39 seats and 2 supernumerary seats. Supernumerary seats are actually addition to the intake of 39 seats, and these 2 supernumerary seats each are reserved for JNK domicile and foreign students. Classes, like one of you have actually commented this question as to when can you expect the classes. So it will be, the schedule is Monday to Friday 9:30 a.m. onwards, and Saturday Sunday both days are off. Mode will be online due to COVID-19 present situation. Fees, your fees will be rupees 92,000 including admission fees of 80,000 per annum. So 80,000 will be your admission fees and others will be charges, like the extra charges. Then the minimum eligibility, LLB degree from any Indian university recognized by Bar Council of India to be eligible for enrollment as an advocate in India with not less than 50%. So this is for general and EWS category. So you need to have not less than 50% aggregate in your LLB degree. For SC, ST, OBC, non-criminal, a relaxation of 5% is given. That means your minimum eligibility will be 45%. In PWDs, again, it is 45%. And for Kashmiri migrant and wards of Kashmiri migrant students, there will be 10% relaxation. That means your minimum eligibility criteria will be 40%. Or LLB degree from foreign university, at least 50% marks in aggregate. Candidates appearing in the qualifying examination is also eligible to apply. In that case, admission shall be provisional by an undertaking and he shall submit the result on or before 15th of December 2021, failing which his or her admission shall be treated as cancelled. Like most of you are in your final year of LLB examination, LLB semester. So in that case, you will be given a provisional admission and also by an undertaking that you have to submit your final result on or before 15th of December 2021. That means this date is the cutoff date for submitting your result, final year result. And if you fail to do so, then your admission shall stand cancelled. Then instructions for Viva Voce. So it is very important. Candidates have to make sure that they are eligible for admission to the course. Any candidate found ineligible at the time of admission will be summarily rejected. Attending the Viva is purely provisional and subject to the candidates being otherwise eligible for admission to the course as explained in the prospectus 2021. So it is very much required that you at least qualify the minimum eligibility criteria, and if you fail to do so, even if you have cleared the Viva Voce examination, then your admission will be cancelled. In case of a tie between 2 or more candidates in the final merit list after Viva for admission, the decision will be taken according to tie breaking rule as mentioned in the prospectus 2021. I have already checked the cutoff list of all the categories and I have found many students have actually got time marks. So in that case, if 2 students are getting the same marks and if they are coming under this tie, then there will be a tie-breaking rule which will be according to the procedure of the institute. Candidates are required to carry their admit cards issued during the Common Admission Test 2021 along with any one of the following identity proof at the time of viva. So now this is actually what to say, this is mandatory that you shall carry your admit cards. So you can also download your admit card by logging into your portal, the link which is already given on their website, and you need to carry one of these given identity cards like PAN card or Aadhaar card or driving license or passport. Candidates under reserved SC/ST OBC NCL, that means non-criminal layer, physically handicapped, general EWS, JNK domicile, JNK migrants category have to bring the latest valid certificate in the prescribed format from competent authority for verification before viva. Prescribed format is available in the prospectus 2021. And if you belong to all these categories like general categories or JNK domicile category, then you need to bring a certificate which actually verifies your category, and the format of the certificate is already given in their prospectus. Then marks distribution. So this is very much important that you understand about the LLM marks distribution. So 40 objective type questions, and in this 40 objective type questions you had questions from English language and general knowledge. That means 40 marks, 1 mark each for correct answer and 1 by 4 for negative marking. 100 objective questions, and the questions were from law subjects. Then 4 subjective type questions, and in which the total marks were 40, 4 questions carry 10 marks and word limit was within 150, and all the 4 questions were compulsory. That means all these 3 parts actually making up to 180. And then viva voce, that is 20 marks after qualifying in the All India Merit List. And now your viva voce will be of total marks of 20. And now I'll discuss with you the cutoff of 2021 out of 179. Why 179? Because one question was cancelled, and therefore it is reduced by 1. Then PWD, if I talk about the PWDs, highest cutoff was 70.75, lowest cutoff was 11.25. For STs, highest cutoff was 56.25 and lowest cutoff was 25. JNK, the highest cutoff was 85 and the lowest cutoff was 39. General EWS, the highest cutoff was 102.75 and lowest cutoff was 85.25. And if I talk about general, the highest cutoff was 120. Like I have already told you about the expected cutoff this year, and I have already mentioned this, that this year you may expect the cutoff above 20. Only 20 or above 120, and this cutoff actually substantiates about what I actually said to you. Then lowest cutoff was 93.75 in general category. OBC non-criminal layer, the highest cutoff is 123.75, so it is actually 3.75 more than what a general candidate secured, and the lowest cutoff was 75. If I talk about SCs, the highest cutoff was 112 and the lowest cutoff was 62.75. So now I would like to explain to you the viva voce syllabus. So as I already told you, total marks are 20 and subjects are jurisprudence, constitutional law, IPC, PIL, commercial law, which includes contract and specific relief act, partnership and sales of goods act, law of torts, law of limitation and environmental law. So all these subjects were the syllabus of All India test for the 100 questions of law subjects, and the same subjects will be there for the viva voce examination also. And let me tell you, these questions are totally suggestive in nature, because mostly these questions have been asked for the past so many years, and this is the reason why I am telling you. But apart from that, the entire subjects which I am telling you are important. So I would recommend you to have a overall view of all the subjects. You should actually go through all the important topics of all these subjects. be thorough with each and everything, because questions can be asked from any side. And nobody is sure about what kind of questions you may face, because it depends from candidate to candidate, and also it depends on the mind of the judges and the mood of the judges. So I'm just giving you an example, like this kind of questions you may get in your viva voce. So the and let me tell you, what do we mean by viva voce? It means an oral examination. And the questions are, first question will be, give you an introduction and tell from where you did the law course and in which year. This is a very common question, and it is almost asked in all interviews. The second, explain strict liability or absolute liability. Then third, explain teen talaq. Fourth, distinguish between culpable homicide and murder. Fifth, whether the causing the death of child in the mother's womb is homicide. Then sixth, explain theft. 7. Elaborate victim compensation scheme, which is given under section 357A of CRPC. 8. Explain permanent, mandatory, temporary and mandatory injunction. 9. How many minimum number of members required to form a partnership? 10. Who is known as the father of English jurisprudence? Then 11. Explain the theory of monism and dualism. 12. Condonation of delays applicable to, so let me tell you, it is applicable to appeals and applications. 13. What is spes sectionis? Can it be transferred? So spes sectionis is actually a right of the right of a person to succeed to his hereditary property, and it cannot be transferred. Then 14. What is section 482 CRPC? 15. A relief of tort is available against whom? 16. SRA came into force, that means Specific Relief Act came into force on 17. What are not goods under sales of goods act? Then 18. What are the rights of unpaid seller? 19. What is, I have already mentioned, also this is actually mentioned, been mentioned twice. 20. Distinguish between indemnity and guarantee. 21. Difference between agent and principal, and who is a sub-agent. 22. A finder of goods have the same responsibility as to that offer. 23. What are the essentials of a valid contract? 24. Who are competent to contract? 25. Explain void and voidable agreements. 26. Agreement and contract is defined under which section of Contract Act? Then 27. When communication is complete, very much important question. 28. When acceptance by post is complete as against the offerer and acceptor. Then 23. What is a novation of contract? 24. When a contract becomes impossible. 25. Can a minor be personally liable for the necessaries supplied to him? 26. Difference between fundamental rights and directive principles of state policy. 27. What is the doctrine of basic structure? 28. Under which article protection against preventive detention and doctrine of double jeopardy is given? 29. Questions on landmark judgments of Supreme Court of national importance. And there are other doctrines also, like doctrine of territorial nexus, doctrine of colorable legislation. You may face this kind of questions. Then 30. Which part of the constitution deals with cooperative society and municipality? So nowadays this question has been seen in many examinations. 31. What is doctrine of judicial review? 32. Disputes as to the election of president or vice president is decided by whom? 33. Which article deals with the pardoning power of president or governor? If I talk about president, it is article 72, and for governor it is article 161. 34. Difference between robbery and dacoity, that means 390 and 391 IPC. Sedition is defined under which section of IPC? 36. Is mere preparation to commit murder a crime? 37. Questions on landmark judgments of environmental law. 38. Municipal Council Ratlam versus Vardhi Chand and others is a case related to. So this is a famous landmark judgment in environmental law, and the case is related to public nuisance. And this question has been asked in the past so many years of ILI LLM entrance examination. Then 39. Precautionary principle was first laid down in the case of, this was in the case of Vellore Citizens Welfare Forum versus Union of India. 40. Which judgment involves the establishment of compensatory for afforestation fund? Again important. So this is actually T.N. Godavarman versus Tirumulpak. 41. Can a minor be admitted to the benefit of partnership? Other important topics. Apart from these questions, all law subjects as per their All India Test syllabus are important. So like I have already told you, you cannot be like what to say, can be dependent only on this type of questions, because there are other topics also which are very important. So you need to have a 360 degree approach to all the subjects, and you need not be very confused, or you need not be very do not panic before Viva, because see, only whatever you have studied so far, just revise only those topics and that's it. Now, how to appear in Viva Voce, this is very much important, because this Viva Voce, your admission to this university is actually very much dependent to the Viva Voce examination, and if you clear it wisely, then you must secure admission in this institute. So you need to have, you need to be careful about few things, like be calm and composed, be loud and clear, do not speak in a high-pitched tone. So do not speak in a very high-pitched tone, just be loud and clear. Like whatever questions have been asked to you, just be clear on those questions, and you should be audible enough to the judges. Then third, answer to the point. Like whatever question is asked, just answer only to that point. Fourth, do not beat around the bush. Fifth, address your answer to all the members of the interview committee. It means like generally, like if there's a panel, there will be 2 to 3 judges. And like general, the tendency is, suppose if a single member is asking any question to any person, that person is only addressing his answer to that person who has asked him the question. Do not do that. You shall have the approach that if a single person, a single member of the committee has asked you any question, then try to answer your question by looking at each of the judges. So that's how you make a good impression to the committee. Then question number 6, do not exaggerate. So you shall not do it. Do not exaggerate your question. Do not exaggerate your answer. Then 7, do not get into serious debate or heated arguments with judges. You shall avoid that. Then 8, in case of contradictions, try to convince with explanation. Now I am giving you an example. This is actually very much common in almost all the interviews. So generally what happens, suppose judge has, any of the member of the committee has asked you one question, like under this section of the Contract Act, the term undue influence is defined. So you would say under section 16 of Contract Act. So now, to confuse you, the judge may say that no, you are just wrong. What said what you are saying? The answer of the correct answer is fraud. Then you shall say, no sir, under section 16 of Contract Act, undue influence is defined, and under section 17 of Contract Act, fraud is defined. So just answer only to that extent. Then 10th, do not give in to wrong answers if protested by the judges. Be confident and be adamant for your answer. Like I have already told you, you shall be adamant with the correct answer. If a judge is actually protesting, if any of the judges protesting that no, you are wrong, the answer is something else, and if you know the correct answer, then be adamant to your answer and be confident. If you feel humiliated, just remain silent. Now this is very much important. Like in most of the interviews, like I have inquired many of the candidates, and they have told me, like at some point of time they felt humiliated, like maybe the judge hasn't treated well or has said something which is very much personal. So if you've encountered that issue, then I would say just remain silent. That's it. You do not get into the heated arguments, or just do not exaggerate your answer, and just you remain silent. Just say, okay sir, thank you sir. That's it. Then appear in clean clothes. Now this is very important, and your clothes should be moderate. And note, Viva Voce will secure an admission, so be wise throughout the interview. And like I told you, like in the, they have only 39 seats, and there are only 4 supernumerary seats. So the competition is very much tough, and this Viva only will actually secure an admission in this institute. So you need to be very wise, you need to be very clever in your answers, and like whatever I have told you, just follow the same, and I'm very much sure that you will go through the interview also. So this is the session for today, and I hope you all have liked it. Do not forget to give a like, share, subscribe to the channel. So till we meet the next time, thank you and have a nice day.